Hello there. This is Colin from Evil G Studios, and yes, this is a gameplay video. So yeah, two things. Really, one reason we're doing this is to try out this new equipment I got. Got ourselves a mixer, some mics. Just for the podcast. Maybe we won't sound like shit next time. Who knows? Some of those guys' voices, even, good God, there's nothing I can do. second thing is, a couple of weeks ago, Darksiders 3 was announced, and I think it's well known enough that Stu is a fan of this sort of thing, so he went kind of crazy, giddy, like a little schoolgirl, over the announcement of that. And I've never played any of the Darksiders, so I thought, let's give it a go. Let's see what all the fuss is about, and why not make a video? Might be shit, might be good, who cares? So went on Steam, picked it up for £9, and here we go, we're gonna start playing Darksiders. I have already played sort of the opening tutorial part, but we'll just go through it again. This could be awful. Don't know how. I don't think this game is that hard. Well, we're going normal anyway. Let's hope I don't embarrass myself too much. Oh, wait.
Since the dawn of time, the armies of heaven and hell
is that gonna default
have waged an endless war. Drawn to the conflict was the Charred Council, an entity bound by ancient laws to preserve order and balance.
Sure.
It held that any great power, unchecked, threatened the very fabric of the universe.
Good job doing, guys.
Heaven and hell came to honor the council and its laws, for none were beyond the swift and terrible justice.
Why is the word council in blue?
A fearsome brotherhood known as the Four Horsemen.
Also the Four Horsemen in blue.
Amid the turmoil, the first humans emerged. The council foretold that these weak but cunning creatures would someday be integral to the balance. Thus, a third kingdom was named.
And everything's okay before humans come along and fuck everything up, as we always do.
A truce was forged between heaven and hell. The great pact was bound by seven seals to be broken at the appointed time, when man's kingdom stood ready for the end war. A battle that would bring balance and determine the ultimate fate of the three kingdoms.
Oh, well, there you go. Bit of background. Yeah, I am playing the War Mastered Edition, so yeah, THQ Nordic. When I originally started playing, I was playing on the original non-War Master Edition. Good God, the PC port of this was an afterthought. A lot of screens here. Let's hope this doesn't do the same. It all got very Warhammer all of a sudden.
Ah!
You'll be safe in there. That is a big hand. Really? Yeah, it works. That was dumb. Sorry. Let's try that again. There was no way I'm playing this with a motion keyboard. Alright. Oh, this already looks way better. Oh, this is a bit one-sided. So yeah, right off the bat playing this, it immediately reminds me of Spawn, the comic book series. And that's kind of what that whole thing sort of put me off the thing, playing this to begin with, when it first came out. I mean, I read my fair share of Spawn. I will get into that. Late 90s, early 2000s comic. If you don't know what it is, go look it up. But yeah, it's a very heavy metal sort of... Heaven, Hell, War, and Spawn, the main character, sort of stuck in the middle of that. But the whole aesthetic here, the way it looks, is very much like a... Yeah, that sort of early 2000s comic book style. Yeah, it's very cool when you're when you're in your teens. Okay. I guess with all this is right. I notice that someone keeps blowing some sort of horn, which makes me shiver each time. This really doesn't look bad for a little bit. It is very loud though. I don't know if you can hear me at all. This whole thing is kind of a... You don't see that much in games anymore, the push whatever button to finish. Followed by slow motion finishing moves. Here. They want me to climb the flash wall. I don't want to climb the flash wall. That looks nasty. What's up with hell and the obsession with making things out of flesh? It looks like I'm... It actually looks like I'm climbing on Freddy Krueger's face. Hey! You dick. Yeah. Where are you going? Climb down the flesh wall. No, come on, guy. We'll leave him. Cross the wire as we go. Yeah, playing this on the, well, sort of the original version just... Oh, everything just looked, yeah, like bad console port. Big, massive prompts. Button prompts, everything looked really sort of cheap. So I don't think it was really a priority. Fuck off, you. Fuck off. Trying to kill me while I'm climbing a damn flesh wall. As if that wasn't bad enough. So from what I've heard about, well, the first Darksiders anyway, is it's a bit of a, bit like a Zelda game. Bit of a Zelda for edgelords, maybe? I do like me some Zelda ones, so. Oh shit. Right, there we go. I ended up going here anyway. So, we're coming up on the first boss fight. Sorry. Well, that's the better if he rips the wings off. Sorry, missed it again. We'll never know. A little bit more.
No. Nope.
Business. It definitely is rocking a bit of a warhammer look to it.
Abaddon, what is this? Where are my brothers?
This cannot be. The final seal.
Come on. My lord. We need some exposition here. What's going on?
How did this happen?
You should really be paying attention while you're on a battlefield. Not the time.
The seventh seal was not broken!
Abaddon!
Whatever that means.
What in heaven's name have you done?
I answer the call.
Is he blaming us for this? We're just minding our own business, bringing about the apocalypse, like we're supposed to. All right, that's how you dodge. Okay. Light bumper. I probably told him at some point. Put that car in your face. Oh shit. Not happy about that. Yeah, give me my stuff to throw at you. Wait, nope. Okay. See, yeah, this is a very Zelda-ish boss fight. Are we gonna have to hit him 3 times? Fuck. Got lazy on that one. And right. Don't worry about it. It's good. It's not good. Okay, not 3 times then, sure. I said blindness before, I swear. Yep. And cause me the best. And B to finish.
Oh. That's just...
Oh, the damn horn. Stop blowing that damn horn. You ruined our moment.
The law has been broken. And so have you, horseman.
I assume we get a horse at some point. I'm gonna be disappointed if I don't get a horse. Being a horseman and all that.
The law is clear. When the seventh seal is broken, four horsemen shall ride forth to punish the wicked. Be they sons of men, lords of heaven, or the dregs of hell. All upon the earth will be judged, and the pact forged anew. You forget your post, horseman. You forget the law. No call was given, yet the destroyer marched.
Is it that big rock that's talking to me right now?
Under his black banner, if the claims are true.
This is out of bullshit.
With your claims.
Fucking bullshit.
The seals were broken.
Yeah.
I was summoned.
Then where are the other horsemen? Were they not summoned as well? The seven seals are hidden, as they have been since the pact was forged eons ago. All of them intact. There was no call. You aided the Dark Ones, broke a sacred covenant that has doomed mankind, and threatened the balance. Do you deny it?
When I rode, heaven and hell were already at war. Abaddon,
this is true.
Was there. He knew something.
Abaddon fell, fighting off the chaos you unleashed.
I fought that was all going on before you got there. The demons, and still you accuse me.
Your defeat proves nothing. Likely the destroyer cast you aside.
These big fighter rocks are dicks.
With you. You
absolute assholes.
The law, horseman. You will be punished.
I serve only the council. Only the balance, as the horsemen always have. Send me back. I will punish the ones responsible.
How? What hope do you have against the destroyer's armies? You are powerless.
Then I will fail, and the demons will have carried out your sentence.
Very well. You will return to the earth. But you will be watched. Come forth.
So there we have our game then. Someone broke these blue apocalyptic horns and tricked war.
The Watcher is bound to you.
Can they come to Earth?
Ensure your loyalty.
Oh, this guy.
Remember that, or I will really get under your skin.
This guy's a creep.
Enough! Rise, war, and arm yourself.
Yeah, so here we are in the council. So you want me to do what now?
Chaos Eater. The angry blade thirsts for destruction.
Why is everything angry? Chaos. Doom and gloom. You're very grumpy, you big fucking rocks. It's Nose Dragon Slayer. Okay. Okay. Harness the power of the Chaos Eater. This attack summons a field of deadly blades around war. We've attained our first wrath power. Or not.
The souls of the dead will be your currency. Some enemies are more easily bought than killed.
So it's everyone's favorite RPG element. Sure, X. Cool. Jump the blue thing. Right. Absorb the blue thing. Yeah, just like Devil May Cry.
Seek the demon Fulgrim. Few can afford his services, but perhaps you can strike a bargain.
The council confers with demons now, does it?
Since the truce was broken, some demons have fallen from the Destroyer's favor. Fulgrim is one such outcast. He has long sought an audience with us.
How long have I been here?
Well, that was the whole thing. Well, this place went to shit.
Looks like our trajectory was a little off. Not so fast, horseman. Let's lay down a few ground rules. Until this is over, you're a dog on a leash. I say bark, you bark. And if I have to kick you, you'd better not bare your teeth. Understand? Or should I teach you to play dead? Good boy.
What an asshole. This game's full of assholes. Oh yeah, the Seraphim Hotel, sure. Get the hell out of here. Oh, come on. So yeah, this is kinda, what am I trying to say here? So I mentioned Devil May Cry earlier. Kind of trying to be like one of those games, like Devil May Cry, God of War, that sort of thing, but much simpler combat. And I think it is really going for something a bit different than those. Ah, zombies!
Here comes the welcome party.
Is this before zombies got a bit...
War?
You know,
why don't you introduce yourself?
Suffer from the overexposure. Yeah, it's been like that for a while. That's a nice view. Oh, that sword you can really rip through these days. Combat feels good. Got wit. Oh, I'm just pushing one button. Version sure looks good. Shit, shit, demon. Well, that was embarrassing. So I guess avoid those guys. They blow up in my face. Okay. Good to know. Should I be reading those out? Maybe you really don't want to read? Maybe you can't read. More flesh wall. Shit. Okay. That was weird. Yeah, this is this is some high level play here. I'm new at this, I've never done it before. Especially the talking and playing at the same time. Alright. Let's try this again. See that? Lock on is being a bit of a dick and changed to... Yeah, I suppose he died there, didn't he? Maybe that's why. Not making excuses, I'm just being awful. Just... what we got? Green floaty skulls. Alright. Alright, we're back up with maximum health. It's all good. It's all good. Main thing is, I haven't died yet. I like that uppercut, that's nice. It didn't even bother reading that at all. It was just telling us how to push this block. Because we've never played a game before. Obviously. I mean, game design, I'm not even going to pretend to know anything about it or think that I can tell anyone what way to do, but shouldn't you really design your games so that you don't need to interrupt the gameplay with a big screen telling you how to do something? I know it can be done because other games do it. You just make things intuitive. I don't think it's the most elegant solution. Minor thing, really, but... Come on. Stop being picky about what you climb on. Fantastic. Oh, here until I kill everything here. I should probably be trying to get bigger combos. Ooh! Nice. Okay, Dark Souls is 8. The dodge, the timing of the dodge isn't, yeah, you can't really pull it. Yeah, I can't interrupt that attack animation, that's it. Lovely. That's all very David Jaffe. Let's make things as violent as possible. Wait. Where was that? Where am I supposed to go? Oh, here we go. Guess not going that way. Health, please. Alright. The crossroads.
How long was I gone?
In Earth years? About a century. Long enough for the last of the mouth breathers to die off.
Then... the third kingdom is lost.
Seems like it. Superhero landing! Had to be done, right? You're gonna jump off something that high. Come on.
Subtle. I almost didn't hear you coming.
Well, suddenly Rogram. Isn't really this game's
the
thing.
The council finally took me seriously.
And who's this guy?
If so, you're sure they're not empty-handed. Subtle.
Look at him.
Or this shall be the briefest of introductions. Blowing
him out with his giant horns and his... like, what the hell?
There were a few young ones.
Oh.
Spectacular.
Well, that's awkward.
You seek the power behind the one called Destroyer. You will find the answers and the font of his power there. Oh, such haste to die. You aren't even a shadow of your former self. You wouldn't last.
He just goes to walk. Like, All right, the guy's over
besides,
there. Right, I'll have to fuck him up.
The way to the tower is shrouded by demon
magic. No nonsense kind of guy is War.
Even I
like
do
him.
Not know the way.
Who does?
Feed my hunger, and I'll feed your curiosity.
Right, I think we should stop now. Yeah, this is promising enough. I'm enjoying it so far. Looks like we just got through the tutorial anyway, yeah, so next time we do one of these, we'll be getting into the game proper. We'll see how like Zelda it is. But anyway, that's that. See you guys later. Bye.